Hey guys, welcome to Picture Book Drama, where it is everything in entertainment. I am your host, Sean, your video and comic guru. Welcome to my pickups for the month of August. Gonna have about 26 plus items here, some DVDs, some Blu-rays, some steelbooks, a couple of box sets in here as well. So it's a little bit of everything, but this is really a video for the collectors because you guys will really understand a lot of the stuff that I buy because I do buy multiples of different movies because it's different versions of it. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Please hit me in that comment section below, hit that subscribe button, let me know what you guys think of what I bought, and if you guys have these things, or if you have items that you're actually looking to sell, please hit me up in that comment section, or you can actually hit me up on Twitter as well. So there's my Twitter information for you. Hit me up on Twitter, I'll get back with you and we can see what we do. But hey, we're here to see some movies, not to hear me talk. So gonna start off with the DVDs. Again, I have a compulsion to buy multiples of things if they're different. So I will just go ahead and shut up and get going. First one I have is Aliens, the special edition. This is the 4-disc DVD version. I love these versions. These versions give you different versions of the movies, gives you a ton of special features in there as well. You get to find out how Alien, the movie, actually came to be, where it came from, who originally created it, and where that inspiration came from. So if you guys haven't picked this up, definitely get this, or get the Blu-ray collection. I believe all these special features may be in there as well. I'll definitely check on that. But if you guys know, hit me in that section, let me know for sure, because I'm not 100% sure on that, but this was awesome. I love this version. Then, of course, if you get that, you have to have Aliens. James Cameron just blew me away. Now, Ridley Scott did Alien, one of the best sci-fi films that came out to date until this came out. This completely changed it around because this was horror, straight up horror. This is actually one of the first movies that scared the crap out of me. That scene where Tom Skerritt's going through the air duct and that one woman's like, he's right behind me. When you turn around and he's just like, fucked me up for years. I couldn't watch that movie when I was a kid. My brother used to watch that movie just to scare me. Oh, bastard. Rest in peace. But Aliens completely flipped it around. It went into the sci-fi action movie genre. Still had that little bit of horror to it. We got the facehugger was introduced, I believe, really well here. I think it was in the first one, but not really pushed that far. You had the stomach burster, but not the face hugger. This was awesome. Sigourney Weaver just killed it in this movie. This came out, I'm not sure if it came out before or after T2. So let me know on that one as well, because I'm not 100% sure. I think it came out just before it, but this was during that time where James Cameron could do no wrong. So you got Aliens, and this is again a 4-disc version. And if you get that, you gotta have Alien 3. Now we're starting to get into the crap. But it was, who directed this one? This was directed by David Fincher, so you would think this is gonna be really good, but it was just so bad. But it had its moments. It wasn't a completely terrible movie. I think this is one with Winona Ryder, isn't it? Let me double check it. Doesn't say it, so I think she was in the fourth one, so. Either way, it's crap, but I got it cheap, so. And of course, if you're gonna do that, you gotta complete the collection with Alien Resurrection. I believe this is the one where Winona Ryder, this is the one where Ripley kills herself at the end. Spoiler, but we were like, just let it go. This movie just didn't know where it was going. It had potential, but it just didn't fulfill that potential. But, you know, you got all four of these. I picked up all four of these movies at Reckless Records for $20. $20 for all four. That's $5 a movie. And you got 4 discs on all these, I believe. I think they're all 4 discs. If not, still doesn't matter. These are the best DVD versions of Aliens that are out there. Awesome. I do have the Blu-ray collection. If you guys have been following me early on when I first started doing my channel, I did an unboxing of the Alien Egg, and I showed that I did have the Blu-ray box set as well. So check that out. Hopefully I'll remember to put that link in there. I keep forgetting to do that when I upload these. It takes so long, but If not, definitely check that out. It is on there. Just look for Alien Egg and my unboxing videos. Now, the next DVD I have actually shown you, I believe, in three different videos before. But it's such a great movie, and there's so many great versions of this. And when I found this Criterion version, I had to snag it. I for 1 second, I wasn't going to buy it, but it's such a great version, I had to do it. And that is Dr. Strangelove, or How I Love to Learn to Love the Bomb. It's a two-disc special edition Criterion version. It's loaded with special features. This movie came out in 1964, and it holds up, especially in this day and age. Awesome movie. Peter Sellers' best movie. You know, George C. Scott is in this movie. It's a ton of stars in here. But I think Peter Sellers plays three characters in here. But, you know, Slim Pickens is in this. Oh, I love this movie. But I have anniversary edition of this on DVD. I also have a steelbook version of this as well. But I had to have this. It's a different cover, different feature, special features in it. Couldn't go wrong with this. This was $6.95, I believe, at Reckless Records, so I had to go for this. And then finally in the regular DVDs, because I do have a box set that I want to show at the end, I picked up Serenity. Now, in my... Well, I haven't actually released this the Steelbook Collection video yet. That's actually going to be released in a couple of weeks, just because I have other things that are going to be up on the channel before that. But I do have a Steelbook version of this as well, in a Blu-ray. So I decided it wasn't opened, and I didn't want to open it yet because I wanted to get a regular Blu-ray. I didn't want to open Steelbook if I didn't have to. And I am still going to get the Blu-ray, regular Blu-ray of that. But I saw this, and how could I say no to that? I mean, I love Serenity, and Firefly is so great. I don't have the series yet because I haven't been able to find it. I don't want to spend a ton of money on it because I know I could find it used. And don't ever say that used DVDs and Blu-rays aren't worth it. Trust me, you can save yourself a lot of money if you do that. But this was a grab. I got this for $4.95. So why wouldn't I do it? So, Serenity. Now, going into the Blu-rays, I got some really good stuff in Blu-rays, but again, for all you collectors, you will understand. For you guys who aren't, I'm going to come off as very stupid. But I ended up getting Star Wars, I call it the original trilogy. This actually has A New Hope, Empire Strikes Back, and Return of the Jedi on it. This is the Blu-ray and DVD version of it, and this was $6.95. This is a 6-disc version because obviously you get a Blu-ray and a DVD version of both versions of it. I do have the box set of it where that comes with all 6 movies. And I do have The Force Awakens. But I saw this and I was just like, I wasn't going to get it. I was like, well, I already have them. I have a lot of versions of Star Wars. I have the DVD collection. I have the Blu-ray collection. But I saw this and I had to get it. Now, with that said, and remember, this is the Blu-ray and DVD version. I also saw this one, which is just the Blu-rays. So I'm sitting there, or standing there, I should say, at Reckless Records, wondering which one to get, because they're both $6.95. Yeah, $6.95. And I'm like, well, this comes with the Blu-rays and DVDs, so this is obviously the smart way to go. But being a collector and this being a different version, or at least a different cover, I was like, I couldn't decide. And I'm like, for $14, I get both. So I got both. So I have a ton of different versions of Star Wars now. And I still want more. I want the original VHS versions that are not fucked up by George Lucas coming back in his later years thinking he can fix this. Star Wars was perfect when it first came out. Why the fuck you gotta CG it up, I don't know, but that's a rant for another time. I actually do have a Star Wars retrospective video out. Please look that up. That's one of my best videos I've done. I've gotten a lot of great responses from Star Wars fans on that one. A lot of people agreed with what I said on that one. So look that one up. If I can remember, it'd be in a link down there for it. I don't always remember that, so I'm sorry. Now, the next one I have is Batman The Dark Knight Rises. I have several versions of this. I have a digibook. I have the trilogy collection a couple of times over. I have a steelbook of this. Why would I get this again? Because it's an awesome lenticular cover. That's why I got the shit. I am stupid, but I love it. This was fucking awesome. It's the same thing there. It's no different, but it was $4.95. I mean, you could fault me all you want for having multiples, but for $4.95, that's awesome, man. I mean, come on. Now, one that I didn't have before, and that is Nightmare Before Christmas. I really wanted this movie. I don't know why I never got it before. This would be my go-to on Halloween, next to Halloween. I love this film. I do want to get the version that comes with the head that's like this. It's incredibly expensive. I'm drooling because I want it so bad. I'm going to put a picture right there of it. Bink. It is gorgeous. It is incredibly expensive, though. I have not been able to find it for less than $150, and I can't justify spending $150 for one thing. But I will eventually get it. If I can get it for $100, I will do it. But it has to be brand new or close to brand new. That way I know I got everything with it and it's not messed up. So, but this is just a Blu-ray DVD combo pack. It has a ton of special features on here. Oh, so much stuff. So, I mean, you can spend all day just looking at special features on this. I mean, same image. That's one thing with slipcovers. I love slipcovers. I used to always throw my slipcovers away before I started really collecting. But now I hunt these things down like there's nobody's business. Even when I first started doing this, I didn't care if they came with a slipcover. But I started to see other YouTubers, and when I started looking stuff up, I realized that your collection is more valuable with the slipcover. So anyone that don't want slipcovers, send them to me. Hit me in that comment section or hit me up on Twitter. I will take them. I want them. Gimme. And I'm also, just so you guys know, I am looking to start a library. And by library, I mean I want to collect DVDs, VHS, Blu-rays, Laserdiscs, betas. I want the big film reels. I want every version of media out there because I want to show the evolution of technology from where we started to where we are now. So anyone that has a collection out there that they are looking to sell for a reasonable price and in good condition, please hit me up. The best way to hit me up, and I've said it several times here, is with Twitter, right there. I want to make this collection great. I will probably start looking to buy stuff probably closer to Halloween, but I am looking for people who are looking to sell in bulk. Biggest thing I am looking for to start off with, doesn't matter. How's that for an answer? I used to be like the sci-fi horror superhero movies, because I do have a lot of them. If you follow me, you know that. But I want everything. I don't want to discriminate, you know, from, you know, dramas or anything else. I have a lot of comedy. I just don't show them a lot because I haven't done a comedy video yet on my collection. That's coming up a little bit later. But I just dropped a hit on Twitter and all the other social media sites that I'm on, giving an itinerary of what I'm going to be doing over the next 6 weeks, what videos are going to be coming out. So if you guys see that, you know I have a lot of stuff that's going to be coming out. 2 per week, I think, for the next 4 to 6 weeks, on top of all the other stuff I do. So I got a lot of stuff in the works right now. And with Halloween coming up, I'm probably going to be doing a ton of videos in October. So let's just keep going. But yeah, I definitely want to create that library. So hit me up. Let me know what you guys have. I don't do trades right now because I don't have anything to trade. You know, I don't want to sit, you know, believe that in, out there making people think I am looking to do trades. I don't have anything to trade right now. Everything that I'm buying to keep. If that changes, I will definitely let you guys know when that happens. And I say a lot. I notice that. But here we go. Back to the pickups. I got X-Men First Class. Twice. I couldn't decide which one I wanted more. I have never seen this cover with Magneto on it. And I like this because it's a different picture in there. That's rare. So rare. I had to have this one. So this one I had actually walked around reckless with. This was actually $4.95. And I saw this one at the same time. But I wasn't going to get that one because I wanted the Magneto one. But it was just, it was in my head. And this was, I bought all these at the same time. And I was just like, well, I already got multiples of Star Wars. I got the whole Alien collection. Why not? $4.95 again. And guess what? Different inside. I love that. Again, this is the selling point for me to really get this, because I was really on the fence. But when I pulled the slipcover up and I saw it was a different cover, cover art, I had to go for it. Now, on the back, you do have the Magneto face, like with this one. With this one, you get what's in there. So, I mean, win-win for me. And, you know, they're both Blu-ray versions of it. I am, right at the present moment, keeping my digital copies because I am creating a digital copy library as well. So I wanted to create a wealth of information of what is out there. But, I will be giving away digital copies at the end of the year. I know it's a little ways off, but I have to pull together what I have multiples of and pull those digital copies out. And they all still work. Don't let anything say on these things say expire. They don't expire. They don't. But what can happen is they put the wrong movie in that digital code. Because I have Goonies, and I was putting a digital copy in because I use Flixster, and Tammy popped up. I'm looking at the damn thing. I'm like, what the fuck happened? And I type it in again, and they're like, yeah, it's Tammy. Why the fuck would I want Tammy? I was so pissed. I thought, oh, man, sweet. I got a digital copy of the Goonies. Nope. I got to go get another. There's several versions of Goonies that I want to get, but that pissed me off. Now, we're on to the next stuff. I want to get the stuff in order. One movie I got that I haven't watched yet, and I'm not sure if this movie I may not end up keeping if it's bad, because I'm not really into these type of movies that much. Noah. I don't really watch a lot of biblical movies, and if I am, and I do want to get the Ten Commandments, Ben-Hur, I do want those two. I will probably end up getting The Greatest Story Ever Told, just because I want those. If I get those two, that one will actually be the completion of it. But the only reason I got this because of the slipcover. It's rare to find this with a slipcover. Same image, but for some reason, at least here in Chicago, it's hard to get this slipcover. So I got it. You know, it's a Blu-ray. It was, I think it was $6, $6 or $7. I wasn't sure on that, but I just said, okay, if I'm getting all the rest of these, I went and got this one too. So a lot of these I bought all at once, so they love me there. I spent a ton of money, and I don't ask for anything. A lot of people there who will go there and try and haggle. I'm like, you know what? These are great prices. I'll just go ahead and pay it. I'm lazy. Now, one movie that I am so glad that I got and was able to get it at the price I got, Casino Royale. Probably the best Daniel Craig James Bond movie that he's done. This movie was so great. This introduced us to Daniel Craig as James Bond. A completely different version, almost going back to the Sean Connery version of James Bond. A little bit bulkier, more physical, not trying to do martial arts and all that, but a guy who was a brawler. And you get to see the early years of Bond, how he was a hothead. I love this movie. And Eva Green's in this. I love Eva Green. You know, back image, great. I wish they had the paper part that sticks to it. I keep those as well, but, you know. Now, I got the movies in my player right now, but that's the image that you get. That's your interior artwork. But, I mean, let's face it. It's Eva Green, man. And those eyes. Oh, those eyes. So hot. So hot. Love her. But I got this for $7.95. I looked this up on eBay. This thing can run you $35. So, I mean, I saved myself, like, what, $28? And the condition is fantastic. I probably wouldn't get it in this ungraded condition on eBay sometimes. Sometimes you get screwed. Very rarely has that happened to me, but it does happen. Now, another one, a brand new one. Yeah, because there's very few brand new movies in here that I don't have in my collection already. And I only got this because I haven't seen the show at all. And Black Sails, season 2. I don't even have season 1, so this is going to have to sit until I get season 1. See if I get rid of that glare. And again, it's a wonderful lenticular cover. I love that. That drew me to it. This was a little bit more expensive. This one was $12.95. So this was one I kept picking up and putting back down, but I noticed it was the only copy of it that they had, so I had to get it. So I do have that one. And, you know, it's a 3-disc collection. I wish it had a digital copy in there. They should always give you a digital copy. I used to hate digital copies, but I want them now. Okay. Now, you saw with my Star Wars, I had 2 versions of the original trilogies. I picked up The Hobbit, An Unexpected Journey. Not the biggest fan of this new trilogy that Peter Jackson did because they felt forced. There was no reason for 3 movies. They could have done it in 2, understandably, and gotten away with it. Considering that The Hobbit is one of the shortest novels in the whole Hobbit trilogy, you know, the whole Lord of the Rings series at all. It's a very short book, but it is filled with a lot of detailed information. So I can understand it being 2 movies, but 3? Mm-mm. But I have this in a steelbook as well. I believe I still have the steelbook. I may have given that away. I'm not sure. I'll have to double check it. No, I do. I still have the steelbook. I have it. Now, I got that one. But I saw this one as I was leaving. They put this version up. And the dude knew. The dude knew what was going on because he definitely made sure I was looking when he put this up there. And I was so pissed because I probably would have put this back. Now, again, slip cover, same image, but it has a slip. But this, I mean, same image, but a much better, thicker outer cover. And it just looks like it would be a part of the Hobbit trilogy compared to the other one. So, I got them. I've seen them all. I'm not impressed. I'm not. I remember when the first 3 movies of the Lord of the Rings were coming out, you couldn't wait to go see it. And then when they said they were doing these, at first it was going to be 2 movies. So I was like, okay, I want to see this. Then they said, no, we're going to make it 3. I was like, I know y'all fucking me now. Y'all didn't even buy me dinner. Y'all just going to bend me over and fuck me raw. That's fucked up. And I did not go to the theater to see the last 2 parts. I just waited for them to come out on DVD and Blu-ray. And that's how I saw them. And I saw this one with it, and I wasn't going to get it. Because, like I said, I'm not the biggest fan of this movie. I have arachnophobia. There's a big-ass spider in this movie. So there's a part of this movie where I'm looking like a little bitch turning my head. I'm sorry, people. I don't like spiders. But, you know, it had the slip cover. Now, they had the last part, but it didn't have a slip cover with it, so I left it there. So I do need to get that to complete the entire series. But, you know, same image. Nothing special. It does have some special features, you know, on there. Get it that way. Special features. Special features. So you do get quite a bit out of these special features. That's one thing I do like about the Lord of the Rings movies. You do get a ton of special features in them. You know, maybe not the best content, but you get a lot of behind the scenes items that I love. That's actually, to me, one of the best things about Blu-rays is because they can hold so much more information, they can put all these special features on there. So when you do get Blu-rays and they don't have it on there, you know there's going to be another version out that has it. And just because they didn't put the special features on it, they could call the next version a special edition, which is bullshit. But now, this I saw for months on it, and I just said, I'm not going to buy it. I'm not going to buy it. I only like two of the movies, or actually three out of four, but I owned them, you know, on DVD, which I will end up doing coming closer to Halloween, my collection for this series, and that is Underworld. This is the Underworld quadrilogy, or whatever you want to call it. This is basically the Legacy Collection. It's all four movies. And if you haven't been aware, there is a trailer for the fifth movie, which actually looks good. It looks like they're going back to the first movie. They got Selena looking like a badass fighting the Lycans again. This movie looks good. Too bad Awakens sucked ass, but the first movie was so great. I remember seeing this in a movie, and actually it was close to the time I had just moved here to Chicago. I believe it came out in 2000. Double check that. Doesn't tell me. 2003 it came out, so I was here for a few years. But I remember walking out of the theater with my friend and just going like, this is awesome. This was so great. And the second one came out, not as good, but I still liked it. Then came out Rise of the Lycans, and actually I'll just shut up and just waving this around and just, great movie, awesome, fan-fucking-tastic. They still have not come close to beating this movie or even coming close to, you know, equaling this movie. This was great. This was a movie that introduced me to Kate Beckinsale. I didn't know who she was. But gosh, she's gorgeous. That's the one thing I will say. This woman is absolutely beautiful. Then you got Evolution. Yeah, Evolution. Eh, you know, not as great. Still good. But the villain was just so stupid. You know, one of the villains, he doesn't even talk. He's just a big-ass wolf. I mean, at least in the first one, the Lycans, you understood why they were fighting the vampires. They actually had a legitimate reason. With that said, that's why I loved this movie. Actually, I will say this is actually close to rivaling the first Underworld, because this is the origin, you know, and this one is Rise of the Lycans. I love this movie, mainly because we got Michael Sheen back in it, or Shannon. Sheen, no, I was right the first time. Michael Sheen in this movie. Back in this movie as Lucien. One of the best villains slash anti-heroes that I have seen. You really, in this movie, it's dark. You know, it is, you really begin to hate the vampires in this movie because they basically made slaves out of the werewolves. And you see the uprising and you see the war start. So the war they talk about in the first Underworld, they deal with in this one. And then you get this bullshit, Awakens. I'm not going to talk about it because it sucks. It's horrible. Yeah, this video is going on longer than it should, and I ain't going to waste that talking about that fucked up movie. So this was $9.95. For, you know, 2.5 movies that I liked out of this, it was worth it. So Underworld. Now we get into some steelbooks. Only one of these steelbooks, or two movies in this, I had. So, first one is The Django Unchained. And I do have the white cover of this, that's the best, Target exclusive, that has that cover on it. I saw this, and I actually wanted this one because I do kind of like this type of graphic on here. It was $8.95, you know, and it's in brand new condition, so I had to go with that. Then you got Ender's Game, which is an all right movie. It's not bad. You know, if I didn't see the steelbook, I wouldn't own this in my collection. I'm not going to lie. But it is a good movie. Harrison Ford is awesome in this movie. But the steelbook looks sweet. You know, look at the back of that. That's awesome. This is something that you will display like this. Now, with that said, and I'm gunning through these, you know, kind of quick. Because, again, I've been talking for about a half hour. But RoboCop. If there's ever a movie that looks best in a steelbook is RoboCop. Now, I do have the original one with Peter Weller in a DVD steelbook, but I also have the Blu-ray trilogy of RoboCop, and I also have, I believe, a DVD special edition, lenticular cover of RoboCop. So, a lot of them that I have. But that's the back cover. Love this movie. Because I like Samuel L. Jackson. He just plays some of the goofiest characters, and anytime he throws a wig on, it's hilarious. Now, one of my all-time favorite movies, The Big Lebowski. I have the bowling ball. I don't have the bowling lane yet, but I do have the bowling ball. I love this movie so much. There are so many different versions of this that are out there that I want to get in my collection. But, I mean, this has, for like $9.95, this has a ton of features in this movie. I mean, look at that. This is a great movie, man. This is awesome. This is probably Jeff Bridges' greatest movie. It definitely is John Goodman's best movie. You know, John Turturro played in the Jesus. Oh, man, you got so many people in this movie. I mean, let's just run through. I mean, you got Jeff Bridges, John Goodman, Julianne Moore, Steve Buscemi, John Turturro, and I think Lindsay Lohan is in this movie. I'm not sure who was the girl in the movie. I forgot. I think it's Lindsay Lohan. I might be wrong. It could be someone else. Please hit me in that comment section. Let me know who the girl is. But I got two more to show you, and these are going to be my box sets, if you will. This is actually a special edition. This one isn't really a box set. But in this one, I kind of got screwed on. I will say that up front. I got screwed on this one because there's something missing in this that makes me have to go get a newer version of it. Only reason why I got this is because I got it for $5. And that is the Wolverine. Look at that. Look at that. You see those pictures right there that are down there, those cards? They're not in here at all. You open it up, they're supposed to be right there. They're not. Yeah. You do have the movie, but you just don't have the cards that come with it. And being a completionist and a little OCD, I want that. But I did like this movie a lot. I really wish they had shown that deleted scene had been put in the movie where you saw the Wolverine costume. Even though he wasn't wearing it, you saw it in a box. It looked so sweet. I'm sure Hugh Jackman would have looked awesome in it, and we will never know. Unless they do something in this last Wolverine film where he's in it. And I hope to God they actually show him in the costume, but I doubt it. I think that is coming on, so. But I got this for $5. I had to go for it. You know, if I can just find the cards on eBay, I'll just add them in here. Now, the final one, and yes, I've been talking for a while, but I gave you a lot of information. So leave me alone. And I say here's I say a lot. So here's my last one. I love this last one. This is something that I did not know existed. I don't know how I didn't know this was out there. I knew the individual DVDs were out there, but this is a DVD complete series, Justice League. This has Justice League Seasons 1 and 2, Justice League Unlimited Season 1 and 2. Basically, every episode of Justice League and Unlimited are on here. I love this. And it's metal slipcase. Now, and it even had the back slip on that. I like that. I want the complete thing. And, you know, these are the two sets. You know, this one is Justice League. These are Justice League Unlimited. But it's like, if you guys own the complete seasons, individual sets, that's what's in there. There is a special disc at the end that's basically a history of the making of the Justice League series, a couple more interviews, but the main appeal to this is having everything in one, for one, but it's this. I mean, that is solid. This holds up. You can actually put this on a display and it's not going to cave in. I do like that. That is awesome. This was not cheap. I didn't buy this one at the time. This one I bought separately because it just killed me. It just took any money I had that I was going to buy movies with, and it just went out the window. This was $51.99 at Reckless Records. I looked it up on eBay. I looked it up on Amazon. This can go for $75+, all because of that metal case. Now, like I said, if you own the DVD seasons individually, You already have this. There is just one special features disc on here that's different. So I don't want to, you know, lie to you guys and say, oh, it's completely different. No, it's not. Exact same disc, exact same ones, because I had the individual seasons. It's the same thing, just an extra disc and a metal case. But I am so happy to have this. I still want to get Batman the Animated Series, Batman Beyond, Superman the Animated Series. I just don't have the money to do that all the time. That buying that broke me that day. They knew it too. They were like, just one, huh? And I'm like, fuck you, take my money, shut up. But that's it. That's all of them. That's 26 different things I've shown you. I don't count A New Hope, Empire Strikes Back, and Return of the Jedi as individual ones. If they're in a set, I just count it as one. Otherwise, this is probably about 32 movies right here. But that's it. That's it for this month. Nothing really new that came out, because I've been spending all my money on a lot of the used stuff because I could get more for my money. But with Halloween coming up, I definitely will be switching over to more horror, hopefully. I do love my superhero stuff. That's my bread and butter. I love superhero stuff. But horror is my favorite genre after that, especially the stuff from like the 70s, early 80s. Not once you get into the later Nightmare on Elm Street, Halloween, and Friday the 13th movies where they're just slasher films with no substance. I like the 70s stuff, The Hills Have Eyes, Last House on the Left, The Howling, you know, Halloween. Halloween is my all-time favorite horror film, but we'll get more into that when we get closer to Halloween. If you guys have been following me from the beginning, you know that last year during Halloween, I did a video a day. I'm not doing that. They weren't the best quality. I had literally just started on YouTube. Didn't know anything about it. I got my brother Joe to help me film these, and we were both working full time at the time. So, I mean, literally, we were gunning out these videos, and I really wasn't sleeping. I would, like, make these videos. I wouldn't go to sleep till 4 in the morning. It was hell. It was fun, but it was hell. But this time, I'm not sure what all I'm going to do yet. It may be reviewing sets, because I didn't really review the movies. I kind of showed you what I had, gave a quick synopsis, quick rundown of it. It was a top 31 movies, you know, in order of my favorites, kind of. Not really. I think the last five were really in order. The rest were kind of like, okay, I bought these, I can show these off. I'm not doing that this year, but this year I will be doing something. I'll probably like do reviews on sets, but that's it, guys. Hit me in the comment section below. I'm on a ton of different social media sites. I'm on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Gimmer, Instagram. I just started going on, what is it, Pinterest? I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's down there too. If it's not, don't worry about it. Yeah, it'll be there. Why not? I just started it up, so I did put a ton of stuff up there actually this morning before I filmed it, but I want to tweak it, but it's there. There's a lot of stuff on there that won't be anywhere else, so I want to make each social media site separate, because I used to put everything on everything. I want to give you a reason to go to each one, so I'm trying to stream.